The Doctor, Kevin, and Susie Jo land on the planet Terra-Nova in the 32nd century.
32nd century, Susie Jo. 3147. 32nd century.
While exploring the planet, they find that all activities are oriented around the mind. But this has an even deeper purpose, as Kevin and Susie Jo soon find out.
The golf tickets are reception devices, and those two are the only ones in the audience who have them. That way, we can control their minds and no one will be the wiser. Start the concert.
Right away.
Will the Doctor mind the mind invasion? Stay tuned for the first segment of Mindmask and find out. If you don't mind.
22. 23. 24. Uh-oh. 99. 100. Ah, hello, Doctor.
Didn't hear you coming. I just came to get my sonic screwdriver. Doing push-ups, I see.
Yes. Just done 100.
Well, I won't keep you then.
Oh, boy.
By the way, I didn't know that the number 99 followed the number 24.
What are you doing?
Fixing the primary bridge. The other bridge is too bland. I'm thinking of closing it down for redecoration. That's the trouble with computers. They only think black and white. That's why I'm fixing it up a bit.
Why don't you just take it back to Gallifrey and fix it up there?
I told you I'm not going back there for a long time. And about your chess game with K9 in you, I moved the chessboard in here.
Thanks. Doctor, how long have you been operating TARDISes?
Why?
How many travel mates have you had?
What are you getting at?
Are you sure you took everyone back?
What?
Are you sure you haven't forgotten someone?
Get to the point!
Well, I was walking along one of the corridors when I met some young lady. She's... long red hair built like an hourglass and can make a Catholic priest sweat.
You must mean Susie Jo Parker.
That's a...
No, I didn't forget someone from a long-lost voyage. She's a reporter from the Daily Tribune I met yesterday while you were swimming. I was supposed to take her back to London.
Like you're supposed to be taking me back to Southampton?
Master Kevin, your move!
Thanks, United. Yeah, where were we? Oh, my rook is there. And your piece is there. Now, how did I get out of that? Could I... No, can't do that. I'm stumped.
Forfeit, Master!
No, try moving your rook there.
Hey, you're right. Thanks, Doctor.
Too bad, K9. Looks like you're going to lose your first chess game.
Well, what's your move? Got him stumped.
Level 3, square 24, checkmate.
But how? I can't believe he did that.
You win.
Affirmative.
I bet you're gonna gloat too.
Affirmative, affirmative, affirmative.
He's probably gonna go to brag to Susie Jo now.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Now, let's see if I can't get this bridge fixed.
How come you never used this bridge before?
I really don't know. This bridge is just as good as the other one.
I see what you mean.
It must be the Delta circuit. It was always giving me trouble. Maybe that's why I stopped using this bridge. Let's see.
Enemy drive?
Yeah.
Sonic screwdriver. I've got to put my hand on the console and brace myself.
Doctor, look out! What happened?
You materialized us.
How?
When you grabbed hold of the console to brace yourself, you accidentally hit the materialization button.
Master!
What?
Mistress Susie Jo requests data on the event that presently occurred.
What?
I'm sure she didn't put it that way.
I think she's been around K9 too much.
Well, I think K9's taken a liking to her.
K9, tell her we've materialized.
Specify how we materialized.
Sticky fingers here.
Sticky fingers does not register in my vocabulary bank in the form that you mean. Please articulate the meaning of...
Oh, shut up, K9.
Please.
Now I wonder where we are. Ah, Terra-Nova.
New Earth?
Oh, you'll like this one. We're in the 32nd century. 32nd century, Susie Jo. 3147. 32nd century. Well, let's have a look. Excuse me. Pardon me.
Look at this place.
It's an arcade.
Games, too. Man, a kid would have a lot of fun here.
Interesting. You know, I think you're right. A kid would have a field day.
Games out of over here.
You know, there's something weird about this place.
Yes.
What were you saying?
Look at all these games. Sophisticated they are.
Yes, but
no matter how sophisticated it is,
given my son a screwdriver,
they're all oriented around the mind.
Well, this is the 32nd century, and the mind has an important part to play in some of these games.
Is there something wrong with that? I just find it strange. I thought you'd come to an arcade to relax.
The easiest way to explain it is to open this little thing up and show you.
Now.
Nope.
Now look what we have here. Now what is a secret panel doing inside the mind machine? Well, I can't bring you that. That's beyond me.
Yes, he always does this, Joe.
Show us something.
Doctor?
Maybe you should try again.
Doctor!
What?
A panel just opened up in that wall.
Ah.
Well, coming?
Panel.
Are you coming or not?
Split panel opened by an arcade machine.
Kevin.
Bye.
Come on, Susie Jo.
Wait. Don't go without me.
That new one. He seems a bit too intelligent.
Yes. That tall one with the silly scarf. He's managed to infiltrate into forbidden territory.
Do you want me to go cut his head off?
No, let them go. If they get too curious, I have ways of dealing with them. I want to find out how intelligent this person is. He intrigues me.
Do you want me to send someone to follow them?
No, we can monitor him very well.
Curiouser and curiouser. Why would they hide it behind an old, out-of-order arcade machine? Why don't they just put a...
Wait. Light.
Let's go. Now, that's interesting.
What?
Just a bunch of people working, isn't it?
Yes. The Baron, Curious, Betelgeuse, Saturn,
hired out.
They're from different planets.
This is the 32nd century. Right?
Yes, but do you know what that is?
A humanoid?
It's a Bulzik. But there's only one problem with that. Bulziks never leave their planet. Not for any reason.
What if they were hired out?
Stay here. Mr. Bulzik, Mr. Bulzik. Yes, have a good day too.
I thought you told me a long time ago Bulzik were nice.
They are nice, but that one seems to be in a trance. They all seem to be in a trance of some sort. Wait, what is that?
Look what?
This machine. Let me see. The process is difficult to understand, but it is definitely a mind control device of some kind.
A mind control? What's it down here?
I think that this is powerful enough to control every mind in the quadrant of this galaxy.
That's impossible!
No, it's not impossible.
The power would be enormous.
Yes, it would be enormous.
It takes a lot to break through the alpha and beta waves of the mind to control it.
Yes, but not...
Oh, no.
I hope not.
What?
Let's keep moving.
Did you hear what he said? He knows that that's a Bulzik. Bulziks never leave their planets. Unless that mind is under control.
Don't you think I know that?
Then let me go cut his head off.
No. I have an easier way. Order the humanoids down there to attack and kill the three intruders.
I will start immediately.
Yes. Now! Stop. I have another use for them.
What are you going to do now?
All in due time. All in due time.
You know, I still can't shake the feeling. What's the matter, Doctor? My hair's curly. It either means it's going to rain, or that something strange is coming.
Kill the doctor. Kill the doctor.
They're gone now.
Oh, thank you. Whoever you are.
I am John, this is my assistant, Mark. I am so sorry for the incident that occurred down here. How did you get down here? You are...
Well, actually, it was a secret panel,
you are,
and,
I'm Kevin.
Excuse me?
No, and you...
I'm Susie Jo, and...
I beg your pardon.
This is the doctor.
There was a secret panel, you see, there was a special little button, and the button was pressed, and I found this corridor, and,
Yes, yes. Are you two hot?
There was one time that, I also, my mother was good, too, to me, you know, yes,
a little bruised.
And there was
a little bruise.
What?
Are you alright?
Oh, yes, I'm fine. How come you have a Bozic here, and,
Come this way, we'll lead you out of this passageway. You know, this is the forbidden zone. How did you three get down here?
I just told you.
Where? Button?
Yes.
Oh.
Oh, another question. What about these creatures?
This way, it leads to the personal key. This way. What was your question?
Why are all these aliens around here?
Oh, I hired them out, yes.
You hired out a full Zik,
you see? What happened around here, Kevin and Susie Jo.
May I talk to you, please? A full Zik never leaves his planet, and he seemed to be in quite a disposition. Can you tell me why?
You'd be surprised what some people do for money. I must apologize once again for the unfortunate incident.
Who are you apologizing to, me or them?
I'm apologizing to all three of you.
Really?
I'm very sorry for what happened. You three must be extremely tired.
Indubitably.
There's a concert that is about to take place in the pavilion. I, being a privileged official here, would like to give you tickets to the show. Alas, I only have two.
Well, you two go. I'll fix the TARDIS. No arguments, Joe.
Well, thank you, Mr.
Just John.
Thank you, John.
I'll see you at the concert, then.
Well, have the gold tickets been distributed?
Both of them. To a male and a female. How old are they?
The female looks to be 26, and the male 43 or 44.
The young ones are most susceptible. The female's name is Susie Jo. What is a Susie Jo?
Earth derivative of Susan Josephine.
The male's name is Kevin. You too can be used.
There's one thing you ought to know.
What?
Their friend. Name's the Doctor. He's a Time Lord.
A Time Lord? What's he doing here? I thought they usually stayed on that minuscule planet named...
Gallifrey.
No? This just may work out to our advantage. We won't use them to take over a star trooper. Time Lords are supposed to be time travelers, am I right?
Correct, but what are you getting at?
Am I mistaken, or did I see a police box just outside this complex?
Yes, as a matter of fact, there is a police box outside. Let me cut his head off.
They call them Time and Relative Dimensions in Space, or TARDIS in its abbreviated form. I believe this is a TARDIS, and we could use his two friends out there to get it. You see?
Yes, but I still want to cut his head off.
You can cut it off later. Is the mind mask tape in position?
It's all ready.
Good. The gold tickets are reception devices, and those two are the only ones in the audience who have them. That way, we can control their minds and no one will be the wiser. Start the concert.
Right away.
I can't believe we got the best seats in the house. I know, Susie Jo. Keep quiet, the concert's starting.
Ladies, gentlemen, and others, Terra-Nova's proudly presents the Dipper!
Thank you. So good of you to come. What you will do is this. Take these rings. Wear them. Always. You will hunt the doctor down. When you find him, you will prick him with this ring. This will inject a poison into him, which will kill him. Then, you will inject yourselves. Do you understand?
We hear and obey the voice of our master.
What diabolical use does John have for the Doctor's capsule?
Capsule?
Sorry, TARDIS.
I am a Xylon, and I'm going to eat the life out of this galaxy. Literally, eat the life out of this galaxy.
I always wondered what Xylons eat.
A very difficult menu to fill, but it seems that John has a proposed item for today's main course.
You will be my next meal.
Well, I must warn you, the Time Lords are very fattening.
I'll take up exercise.
Will the Doctor be able to save the galaxy from John's unique appetite?
There's no telling.
Tune in next time and find out.
Affirmative.
Thank you.